There are way too many videos that touch on this same topic, but they never get to the real issue. They are all going to tell you to just stop watching tutorials and just start making things, which on paper sounds like a good advice. But how are you going to start making things when you don't know how to make things? You always feel like you can't make anything without watching a tutorial. Or if a tutorial on a specific topic does not exist, then you can't make a feature. That is what we call a tutorial hell. So I'm going to tell you how to get out of it from my point of view. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like and share this video. Here's the short answer. You are not learning programming. But first, let me explain. Most beginners, when they start learning game dev, they skip the programming part. They just jump straight into Unity. Then they become exposed to Unity's built-in components like rigid body or collider. You learn when you add a rigid body to a game object, it falls down, and to stop it, you have to add a collider to a standing platform and to a game object. It's actually good to learn this, but it gives you a false confidence that you learned something when in theory you did not. These built-in components are built by somebody else and not by you. It was built by a programmer that works in Unity on a Unity game engine. And you are just using things that were built by them. You might get angry at me for telling you the truth, but I would pay somebody to tell me this earlier in my career. You are just using tools that were made by other programmers, and that stops you from effectively learning programming. So you become just a user. All you are doing is just attaching components to game objects, but that doesn't make you a better programmer. I remember back in the day I learned about Unity's AI navigation system. It is a tool that helps you to move AI game objects around map in a 3D space. And later I was hired by a client to build him AI in 2D space, and I couldn't do it because the AI navigation system only supported 3D. There was no way for me to build it in 2D because I was incompetent programmer. I did not understand how things moved under the hood or any logic behind it. I was only able to build things that Unity provided for me, so I had to cancel that project. Whether you want to admit or not, but this is probably how most of you are approaching game development. On surface, it looks good, but it does not. So in the next step, I'm going to show you how to get out of tutorial hell. First thing first, you must learn programming, and there is no way around it. The only reason why you are in a tutorial hell is because you are not actively learning programming. I see so many beginners try to go around this by buying too many third-party assets on the asset store, but in the end, they realize that they can't build anything beyond what these assets provide. And if something does not exist on the asset store, then they are not able to build what they envisioned. And also, third-party assets dictate how your game is going to look and feel. So my advice to you is to avoid asset store as a beginner. The only exceptions are things like graphics that are only made by artists. Mostly those things that programmers cannot make, like 3D characters, environments, visual effects, shaders, etc. Or things that are too complicated for beginners to make, like networking. I myself still use libraries built by other programmers because I never had time to learn networking from scratch. And these are some good exceptions, but most things you can build yourself. Now, let's get to the point. What do I mean you are not learning programming? I told you about Unity's built-in components, but also you can build your own. And to do that, you must learn how to program. To build your own stuff, you don't need to know everything in C#. All you need to know is bare bones or fundamentals. Let me name few for you. Primitive data types, non-primitive data types, loops, and basic data structures. And that is it. Also, there are other things to C#, but this is what you will need 99% of the time. Many beginners think that they need to know some giga magic functions that do who knows what. But in reality, you only need to know basics. And once you understand this, you will unstuck yourself from a tutorial hell. You are going to be able to write your own components. Also, there are other things to C# and Unity, but you will learn them easily once you learn the basics that I just listed. Everything that exists in C# and Unity was probably already written in combination of these basics. And another thing that I want to point out when dealing with these built-in Unity components, I don't want you to think that you have to write your own physics from scratch. You can just use rigid bodies that works for 99% of the games. Unless you are writing a game engine from scratch, but that has nothing to do with this video. But whenever you are watching a tutorial and somebody is calling rigidbody.velocity or rigidbody.moveposition, I don't want you to follow the same. I want you to go to Unity documentation page and read everything about rigidbody component. Why it is used, why does it exist, literally everything. The reason why I said that you are not actively learning programming when you are using built-in components is because you skip the fundamentals. You might be able to call move position, but you are going to have a hard time understanding it because you never learned about classes or methods. Basically, move position is a method, but you don't know that because you never learned about methods. So what I want to say is, if you learned about rigidbody before you learned about classes and methods, you are going to have a hard time. I do not want you to build a roof before you build a wall. This is something that I went through, and I wish this not to happen to anybody else. There are some programmers on the internet that argued with me that it is impossible that there are developers who can build games but not understand fundamentals. But what they fail to understand is that they come from different backgrounds. They are just developers who went to college and were forced to learn about data structures and algorithms, then they move to something more of a high level. So they never went through this phase where they built roofs before walls. So they believe that everybody learns the same way. They don't understand that game development is a hobby-inspired industry. So countless programmers just skip programming and they just hack around with Unity. They just slap a rigidbody to a game object because they saw it in some tutorial. Or if they get stuck, then they just buy an asset on the asset store. But if they really get stuck because they bought too many third-party assets and now their project is obsolete because it is impossible to maintain all these assets, that's when they discover my channel and subscribe. And you should do the same if you like this video. Also, I do these one-on-one paid mentorships where I can help you to get unstuck from tutorial hell, and for more info, look at the description. And if you're not able to afford a paid mentorship, then I have a Discord server where you can get help for free. Yes, absolutely. To this day, almost after 10 years of experience in Unity, I still watch tutorials. I just watch them in a different way, just to get a quick summary of what a specific feature does. And then I complement it with documentation if available. The most experienced developers also watch tutorials, and there was no shame in it, because nobody knows everything and programming is a profession where you never stop learning. You just have to be aware of how you consume tutorials. Try to not get too dependent where you cannot build anything without watching them. I know there are countless of you who just want to make a dream game and make success, but 99.99% of the time it will not happen. It's just the reality, and you must have a plan B. And if your dream game fails, which will happen, then at least you can get hired as a programmer and not become homeless. I have some friends who never moved past tutorial hell, and they are just working on these low paid freelance gigs, and they are barely moving in life. At some point in your life, you are going to hit age of 25 or 30 and you will have to pay for your bills, and that is something that you should take seriously. This is it, guys. Thank you for watching the video, and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video.